What is up, guys? Jimmy, your Chaos Silencer. Welcome back. Got some Black Ops gameplay for you. Played with some subscribers the other day. Had a blast. And Black Ops really is easy mode, even when you haven't played it for a long time, but it was very enjoyable. I believe I get the Blackbird twice, Chopper Gunner once, and a Gunship once. But you guys enjoy that in the background. And today we're going to talk about wild cards for Black Ops 2. And if you don't know what that is, the wild cards are put in to kind of shake things up a little bit in this new 10-point allocation system to create your class. And you can spend one of your points to do a certain number of things with these wild cards. I'm going to go over them real quick and get your thoughts on them. There is, from what I see here, there is 8 of them. That could change by the time launch gets here. I'm not for sure. This is courtesy of Charlie Intel. Link in the description to his channel. He's the source. And the first one is Primary Gunfighter. It allows a third attachment for the primary weapon. That opens up a ton of possibilities. And then on the negative end of it, that opens up a ton of possibilities. I mean, having a third attachment, let's say, okay, you got extended mags, a red dot, and then you could have a noob tube on it if you wanted to, or just the millimeter scope, the laser dot designator, and a grip. I mean, there's just all kinds of possibilities with Primary Gunfighter, so it should be interesting to see how that turns out. Let me know what you think of that one. Second one is the Secondary Gunfighter. Allows a second attachment for the secondary weapon. So now, you can beef up the secondary weapons with two attachments. That's what he was talking about, David Vonderhaar, when he was speaking of total versatility when it comes to create a class and customizing your weapons. The next one is Overkill. Take a primary weapon as your secondary weapon. We've seen that in the past. That's not that big a deal. Now remember, if you use these wild cards, you're giving up a slot. You're giving up a point towards your system, and your create a class system. You got to remember, if you're used to the normal Call of Duty type classes and that's what you want, you've got to spend all your points to get everything. We're talking everything is in here: secondaries, primaries, tactical grenades, knives, perks, everything. You have to really think about what you're going to sacrifice when you're doing this. The next one is Danger Close. Take a second lethal, not that big a deal. And then when we get down to Perk 1 Greed, you can take a second perk from Tier 1. Now this is where it gets dicey, okay? So as we know, we've gone over the perks before. So Perk 1 Greed, you can take a second perk from Tier 1. So you could technically go, and the douchebag move would be to take Ghost and Blind Eye. Or a cool move to me would be to take Hardline and Lightweight, or Flak Jacket and Lightweight. I think that'd be really cool. The same with the next one, Perk 2 Greed. Take a second perk from Tier 2. So you could, well, if you really wanted to, this is what scares me, okay? Somebody's going to get a primary gun, couple attachments, and then they're going to go crazy on this, and they're going to have Ghost, Blind Eye from the first one, Cold-Blooded and Fast Hands from the second one, or Hardwired, where you're immune to counter UAV and enemy EMPs, and then they're going to go to the third one and get, let's see what's in here, Dead Silence and Engineer. I mean, they won't have any slots left for anything else, but still, they're going to be at an advantage when it comes to the score streaks. I don't know. We'll just have to see how it plays out. And Perk 3 Greed Wild Card is same thing. You could get two. So you could take Extreme Conditioning and Dexterity and climb ladders and mantles over objects faster and recover from melee faster and aim faster after sprinting. The possibilities are endless with these wild cards. And the last one is Tactician. Take a tactical grenade in place of your lethal grenade. Not that big a deal. The really big ones that are up for debate is the three perks. And then a little less would be the primary gunfighter and the secondary gunfighter, depending on how people would try to abuse having three attachments on your gun. And obviously now, some of those guns aren't going to take three attachments, so I'm assuming there's going to be a point in there where it says you can't use this for this gun, like if you wanted to try to over-customize a shotgun or something like that. We'll have to wait and see. But I want to know what you guys think. What do you think about these wild cards? Do you like them, or do you think it was an unnecessary implement into the game? I'm up for debate so far. I'm going to have to wait and see. I know people are going to find a way to take advantage of these. They always do. I mean, that's what people do, or at least the douchebags and D-bags of Call of Duty. They'll find a way to to use it to their advantage where it's a real D-bag move. But we'll have to wait and see. That's it, guys. If you missed it, yesterday me and Minnesota Burns put up the top 10 Hollywood best asses. You should go check it out and give your opinion. And as always, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate all the support. Peace.